Good afternoon, and welcome to Abington Presbyterian Church. So happy to see another enthusiastic audience for our third Tuesday noon organ recital concert series. This is given in part by the Philadelphia chapter of the American Guild of Organists and the Music at Abington concert series here at Abington Presbyterian Church. I want to also say a welcome to our viewers joining us on YouTube on our live stream, and thrilled to have you here in the house as well. Just a reminder to please abide by our pandemic safety guidelines, social distancing, and wearing masks while in the building. Thank you. I'm so happy to introduce Aaron Patterson, who's our recitalist today. Those of us in the area had the pleasure of watching Aaron grow up from a marvelous young organist to absolutely consummate young organist. So we're so thrilled to have him here today. Please take a minute and read his biography on the reverse side of your program. And while you're there, you can take note of some upcoming events that Music at Abington will be presenting soon. So without further ado, let's warmly welcome Aaron Patterson. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for being here, and thank you so much to Eric and John and to Abington Presbyterian for having this event. The Cantabile by Cesar Franck comes from a set called Trois Pièces, which was written for the dedication of the new Cavaillé-Cole organ at the Trocadero Theater. Cavaillé-Cole was a revolutionary organ builder and was notable for the advances he brought to the symphonic organ movement, meaning that the organ could not so much imitate as evoke the presence of a symphony orchestra in its range of color and dynamic. I think Franck's piece aptly demonstrates this, as our imaginary orchestra has a sort of a dialogue between a large group of string players, perhaps, and then a smaller group of string players, and perhaps a solo oboist. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Dana Suesse was not a composer for the organ. In fact, this next piece is a piano piece originally. However, she did study the organ and by all accounts was quite able with the instrument. She was known in her own lifetime as the girl Gershwin, and the comparison is not an invalid one. They both lived roughly the same time. They both straddled sort of the line between Broadway jazz composer and classical composer. And in their works, you find a sort of fusion of the multiple styles. This particular piece, I think, will demonstrate the sort of fusion between Broadway sonorities and classical music. David Hurd is the organist at the Church of St. Mary the Virgin on Times Square, which is quite notable in the organ world and music world. He is a graduate of the Juilliard School as well as Oberlin Conservatory, and he is well recognized for his abilities as an improviser, performer, and composer. And I think one of the trademarks of both his improvisational style and his compositions is his masterful use of post-tonal harmony. And I think these two pieces will well demonstrate that. Daniel Ficarri is a recent graduate of the Juilliard School. He also is a recent joining staff member of the Cathedral of St. John the Divine. He is well recognized both as a performer and composer, much like David Hurd. And in these two pieces, you will see kind of the talents of his harmonic writing also. The Exultation was written for the dedication of the organ at St. Thomas Fifth Avenue, which was an organ that was surrounded in much controversy because there were many who were not so happy that the old instrument was being replaced. And so I think Daniel really captures the sense of kind of mystery in the Exultation with, will this organ be liked? Will it be well received? Will it work? And so I hope you enjoy. I thank you again so much for being here.